It is a new month, so it's a good time to add reading to your list. Local authors Liz and Lisa, they're here again with your June book clubs. Always a good one in there, a really good one in there. Who do we have? What's first?
Oh, hi. So first we have The Beach Trap by Allie Brady, which is a pseudonym actually for another co-author team.
Okay.
So I loved this book. I was in a major slump. I feel like I'm always saying that, but this...
You do say that.
I get in slumps a lot. And then I'll... Anyway, so I love this book. It's about two girls who, when they're 12 years old, they go to this summer camp and they become best friends. Well, at the end of the camp, they realize they're actually half sisters with the same dad.
Okay.
Long story. Okay. So they lose touch. Like, it's kind of drama, they lose touch. Fast forward 15 years, that their father dies and leaves them a joint inheritance of this dilapidated beach house in Destin, Florida. And because of a lot of factors, they actually have to come together to, they need to redo the house themselves. So obviously there's a lot of animosity, a lot of issues. Of course there's two pretty hot handymen.
Of course there are.
Around. But what I really loved about this book is it actually has a lot of depth about family and abandonment and all of, a lot of issues. So a lot of things for book clubs to sink their teeth into.
Okay, that's like a movie. You know,
yeah.
Like some of these books, you explain it, I'm like, that could be a movie.
This would be a great movie.
That would be a great movie. Okay, so the emojis, by the way, if you've never seen this before, the ladies then describe it in emojis. So how would you describe it?
Okay, so the first emoji is the two girls that's representing the sisters.
Got it.
And then a house. I got really obvious, it's a house. And then a hammer, because like everyone's has hammers and they're hammering and they're like doing hammery things.
Doing hammery things.
Yes.
All right. What do we have next?
All right, well, we have The Handler by M.P. Woodward. He lives in San Diego part of the time we actually met him.
Ooh.
Now, he himself is a former operative in the military, so that he lends himself a lot of authenticity to this book. It's about a disgraced CIA operative who is pulled back into the field by his ex-wife, who has to be his handler. Now, she's also in the CIA. He does not want to come out, but he does it for her. And she has to lure him in. And it's because the mole who's been protecting the country, he's been keeping a huge terrorist attack at bay, his daughter died. And so he's kind of lost it. And so now this former CIA operative has to go in and kind of convince him to help the country.
Oh, it's like
really
big,
good. It's very long.
It's very long. It looks big.
But it's really good.
Okay.
It's very juicy. And I think it's going to be a movie. When we met with him, he said that.
Yeah, because that's
several,
a movie.
This is a movie.
That's a movie.
There's
too.
So much more to it. It would take too long to get into, but it's awesome.
Well,
book.
Describe it in your emojis then.
Okay, so I started with this guy because he does not want to come back into the field.
Got it.
And he doesn't want to come back with his ex-wife, that's for sure.
Okay.
And then that's the ex-wife because she's the handler and she actually has one of the most important jobs of all. And then holding hands because they have to figure out how to work together on this huge crisis.
That sounds good.
It is very good.
Okay, then you have your buddy
read. Yes.
What is that?
Ooh. The Lies I Tell by Julie Clark.
Okay.
Now this is a domestic thriller. It's so juicy. This too could be a movie. It's about two women, a journalist and a con artist. Now this journalist has been tracking this con artist for years and years. She finally finds her and she has to befriend her. And once she does, she learns a lot of things and this con artist maybe isn't as bad as she seems. She's conning all types of people and so she seems really bad, but there's reasons for her behavior.
Reasons and for conning people?
Yes, actually. Yes. Stick with me here on this. Yes, there's reasons for conning people. I mean, she's not all good either, but the reasons are pretty layered.
Do we have emojis for this?
Yes. Yeah, we do. So there's a shadow person because she's kind of, you know, going in and out, becoming different people, representing that. And then the scales, because as Lisa mentioned, like, and I think this is true for all people. She's not all good or all bad. And you have to kind of decide for yourself, like, what that percentage is. And then also the emoji. Because that's for the ending, because you won't see it coming.
Oh, well,
and I really kept trying to guess. And I had it totally wrong. I know you did, too.
Well, so you made it easy for me to pick, because now I'm intrigued about this last one.
Oh.
Yeah, because I want to know what's happening. I want to know why you're conning people, number one. And then I want the
Yeah. Ladies. I knew that emoji would get you.
Yep.
Thank you.
Yeah,
thank
you're
you.
Welcome.
Good stuff. Hey, by the way, if you want to look at any of these books, you want to get them for yourself and read, unlike myself, FoxSexSanDiego.com. Click the Xenon tab. And we look forward to your next book picks very soon.